Hey there. Thought I would do a quick Facebook Live. I have an invitation. You guys share this. It is an invitation starting next Monday. I'm going to wait for a couple of people to get on here. If you're catching this later, you guys share this. I believe this is going to be a powerful, powerful, powerful idea. It's something that me and my husband do together. You know, the Lord said not to forsake the gathering of ourselves together, especially, you know, as time goes on, as we get closer. Good afternoon, Melody, Jennifer. I have an invitation. So, hey, Tioni, Bonnie, and... So, some of you guys catch my Facebook Lives live. Some people watch them afterwards. Maybe you don't watch them at all. It's morning in Australia. Tioni, I was reading your diet dilemma. I'm praying for you. Maybe start a garden. But, Lord Jesus, I love you. I want to press in for healing physically, emotionally, spiritually. The other day, I mentioned how I've had back pain for a good long while, on and off. I've gotten deliverance, I've gotten healing, I've been to prayer services where I've gotten healing. Listen, even while I've been hurting, I have prayed and other people have received healing. And so I am believing that my back will be healed. Stephanie, I love you, praying for you, miss you, can't wait to see you again. Carly, Kendra, Pina, Karen, how are you guys? So, you know, as we're doing these Facebook Lives, the Lord is showing up and there's a powerful anointing for healing. And one of the things that I always did with my son, he had several injuries growing up. And, you know, because he's a dancer, and we prayed over him and we got supernatural healing. Many of you guys have prayed for people and gotten healing. And I think we all want to press in and see the Lord do a deeper, more thorough healing of us emotionally, spiritually, and physically. We want that testimony of the miraculous power of God in our lives. And we want our faith to be increased. It messes with my faith a little bit that my back still hurts. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Yes. The Lord, you know, I feel like I've gotten another layer of healing. Another layer of healing in my back. Another layer of healing in my emotions and my soul and my identity. We're pressing in for healing in our identity. You know, when we are walking in who we truly are in Christ, we're going to walk in the miracle working power of God. Our faith is going to be strong. We're going to lay hands on the sick. They're going to be healed. You know, and there's a time and place for everything. I had a couple of people, when I said I was going to put my dog down, say, you know, don't do it. Pray for the dog. And the thing is about healing. You know, there are some healing preachers, you know, that say, you know, you can just lay hands on anybody and pray for their healing and they'd be healed immediately. And if you have enough faith, well, the thing is, you know, faith, true faith, that does not waver has to absolutely know what the will of God is. And sometimes people have stuff going on that we don't know about, and there might be something within them that's blocking their healing, and it's not your faith. There might be something that they need to work out so that, you know, their body's connected to some emotional wound that they need to deal with or heal. And you know, there's a time, I almost posted the scripture from Ecclesiastes. There's a time for everything under heaven. There's a time to live and a time to die. If we could just pray healing over everybody, if we had enough faith and nobody would die, we could raise people from the dead, we'd just be eternal. Even the people that Jesus raised from the dead, they died again. And it was time for my dog to die. And I understand people's sentiment. But, you know, clearly if I'm putting my dog down, I've lamented and I'm certain and I have peace, you know, that it was his time to go, and it was time. I was, otherwise he was going to die, you know, of an infection, poisoning him and really slow, painful death. So anyway, there's that. So even you know, even when we're praying for ourselves, we need to just pray in, press, believe, ask the Lord to reveal any root causes of physical stuff that might be going on. I know what my root cause is, and I know my husband's helping heal my soul, you know, because the Lord's, you know, used the marriage to help heal me, because there was definitely some parallel things, except I was walking in obedience this time around when I was pregnant, and before I was doing my own thing, and the things that happened and came upon me were really from curses and from my own sinful choices. But the invitation that I have is for taking communion together. So I want you guys, if you're on the morning live, and even if you're not, because God doesn't exist in time, if you watch them later, I want you to get some grape juice, get some, you know, crackers, some saltine crackers, or, you know, saltless crackers. Sometimes you can get the little wafers for soup. Those are perfect size for communion, because there's power in taking communion in community and alone. And so the Lord just put it on my heart that we need to be taking communion. I don't know if it'll be every morning, but starting Monday, that'll give people a chance to kind of get the grape juice and the communion or the bread or whatever it is that you want to use. And I want to give communion. I want to take communion together, because when you're hurting, when you're injured, when you are taking communion, you're confessing your sins, you're partaking of the sacrament, and then there is power in releasing your faith, putting your faith there as you take of, you know, the broken flesh of Christ that was broken for us, the blood of Jesus that was shed for our sin. And there's a healing that takes place as you take communion on a regular basis. So if you are hurting emotionally, physically, mentally, and you need another level of healing, I think this is important. We're going to start doing this together if you want to. It's an invitation. I particularly did it when I'm wounded and I would, or my son was needing a healing, and we would press it and take communion until we got it. So I don't think the churches typically give communion enough. This is where the Catholics, I think, do a little bit better. I think they take communion every time they meet together. But we're supposed to be taking communion. So that's the invitation. Let's take communion and let's believe whatever the healing is. And even if it's in your finances, even if it's in your mental capacity, you might be standing in the gap for somebody. We're going to take communion very intentionally, believing that the Lord is going to show up and heal our bodies, restore our youth, you know, just bring another level of healing, a deeper healing, and a deeper, we're recommitting to the Lord just to remember, you know, remember the blood of Jesus and the body that was broken for us. He said, do this in remembrance of me. It really brings us into remembrance. It's a good way to start the day. So let's do it. It's an invitation. And I take, Jesse says he takes communion as led by Holy Spirit. Yes. And me and my husband have been through, you know, he'll bring it to me ever so often and we'll take it. But this is just something that I want to do in this season. In this season, we're coming up higher, new levels of glory, super excited for the healing. And you know, I'm just about tired of my back hurting, to be honest. My son, when he was here, he gave me the best neck massages, because he is a dancer and he's really strong and he knows what he's doing. And he said, we don't let pain stay around as dancers. It hinders our dance, it hinders the flow of our movement, you know, the quality of our dance. And he said, we deal with it. We go to a doctor, we go to a massage therapist, we get acupuncture, whatever it is we got to do, physical therapy, we deal with our pain. And we need to deal with our pain. You know what I'm saying? We need to deal with our pain. Pain is a symptom. There's something wrong. So we need to get to the root of it. And somebody who's on here, and I won't say, you know, because it's their personal business, but they, you know, were talking about cancer. And they were wanting to, you know, make sure that they're eating the right kinds of food so that that cancer doesn't have anything yucky to feed on. They have, you know, their body and divine health, and our spirit and our soul, we need to be feeding on the blood, drinking the blood, feeding on the flesh. You know, that was a teaching that Jesus said, people say, oh, this is hard teaching, you know, and turn back. We can't forget that he told us to do that. It sounds weird, you know, we're not cannibals, but there is power in the blood. There's power in the blood. There's power in the blood. There's power in the body. His body was broken. He was wounded for our transgressions. By his stripes we are healed. We gotta really get together and believe these things until we see them manifest in fullness in our lives. Fullness. Fullness and fullness and fullness. So I will see you guys Monday. You share this. It's only weird if for people who aren't spiritually discerning. And you know, I've had two people tell me that in the background one person said they saw a shadow. It was probably Dave, but they were concerned. And then somebody was concerned about the building behind on the in the morning lives. That's actually another house behind my house. It's strange. It's facing my house. But see, there's a house behind my house. And so I don't know, any kind of weird feeling. It's not our home. But I talked about it this morning, that my daughter yelled out twice in the night last night, and as I was nursing her last night in the rocking chair, I kind of fell asleep, and I heard, "You look ridiculous." You know, it's that state when you're half asleep. The Lord's spoken to me many, many times, and back when I first came to the Lord and was really struggling with demons, that would be the in between the sleep and wake is when they would try to attack me the most, because I'd be half asleep. But it wasn't really an attack. It was a whisper. I guess it was an attack. I didn't feel, you know, like there was some heavy oppression or anything like that. It was just very vague. I'm going to start communion on Monday, because I don't know that we'll be getting out to get what we need for it tonight. And we might start this weekend whenever we get it, but I'll start online on Monday morning. So anyway, we just moved in this home, and Dave prayed when we first got here, but we haven't really had a spiritual cleansing of the house, and so we're going to do that. And we are going to do that this weekend, and we're going to go through all the rooms, we're going to anoint the windows, the doors, and you know, I can't imagine a spirit hovering or hanging around me very long at all. He have to pop in while I'm sleeping, because truly I don't think a spirit would be very comfortable tagging around with me. So anyway, but it was interesting that it's in my daughter's room. They will go after the weakest, you know. I don't know what was going on there, but you know, I don't know if it's from something inside the house, but I'm gonna deal with it, whatever it is. I don't really care where it came from. And also, somebody had said, you know, that they had been having a demon torment their mind for a while, and they told it to leave in the name of Jesus, and it's not going. And when we got off, my husband said he wanted to tell them about the scripture, or remind them, you know, this kind only comes out by prayer and fasting. So sometimes if you're fighting spiritual warfare and it's got the better of you, you need to go on a fast, and you need to press in prayer and fasting, because usually those are generational things. They're a little bit harder to get bust away from, you know. And definitely do a sweep of your house, make sure there's nothing in there that could you know, it could be attached to. Okay, God bless you, and I will see you guys on Monday morning if I don't see you before. You've never fasted, Missy? You got to sign up for the Fasting from Glory to Glory training. There's lots of people on board with that. There's no reason why anybody shouldn't sign up, because I've made it available to everybody. No matter what your financial status, you can give a donation of any amount. I've asked, just give your best donation as unto the Lord, and send me an email or put it in the PayPal. You know, you can go to my website, www.emilyroselewis.org, and go into the store. Or you can do PayPal me, -EmilyRoseLewis. So, you know, get on there and make that donation. I'll send you the ebook and two training videos and a link to our support group. And so the support group is just for fasters, people fasting, you know, whether you're fasting, going on a fast, have a question about fasting, prayers while you're fasting. I really need to do some type of fast myself. I'm thinking about doing a because I can't do a total fast because I'm breastfeeding, but I'm going to do some kind of fast. And I did fasting sugar. Lord, help us. God bless you guys, and I will see you on Monday.